वंदेहं श्रीगुरु।
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, third chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 16th of September, 1972, in Los Angeles, California.
Sri Rupam Chakrajatam सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं त्वं सदीवं।
जय राधा माधव पुण्य बिहारी, जय राधा माधव पुण्य बिहारी, गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी,
ओ समान भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद जी जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णविंद की जय रामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद से अद्वैत गदाधर सुभाष आदि गौर भक्तविंद जय श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गौ गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवदीप धाम की जय स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय गंगा माई की जय जमुना माई की जय तुलसी देवी की जय भक्ति देवी की जय स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असेंबल्ड लॉर्ड ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असेंबल्ड लॉर्ड थैंक यू वेरी मच
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 1 चैप्टर 3 टेक्स्ट 10
पंचमकपिलो नाम
सिद्धेशकालविप्लुतम्
प्रोवाचा सूर्ये सांख्यम्
तत्वग्राम विनिर्णयम्
Translation: The fifth incarnation, named Lord Kapila, is foremost among perfected beings. He gave an exposition of the creative elements and metaphysics to Asari Brahmana, for in course of time this knowledge had been lost.
So, Sankhyam means, Sam means complete, Kham means description. Complete description of creation. Kalavipludam, there is complete description how this cosmic manifestation is created, but people forget it, Kalavipludam. So this knowledge existing since the time of creation, everything materially created has got six stages. The first stage is creation, and the second stage is growth. The third stage is maintenance. This fourth stage is production. The fifth stage is dwindling, and the sixth stage vanishing. This is anything material. The scientists, they are very much busy. Just this morning, our scientist, Sarup Damodar, was speaking about an article. The scientists are very much busy that the source of supply is being decreased. Just like petroleum. Petroleum gas, that is diminishing. The whole modern materialistic civilization is depending on the motor cars and aeroplanes, transportation. If the petroleum supply stops, then what will be the condition of the society? Formerly there was no need of going to see a friend 30 miles away. Because every friend was within the village. Now because we have got motor car, we create fencing with a man who lives 50 miles away. We accept a job 50 miles away. In Hawaii, our Gaurasundar was going to attend office 50 miles off. By 50 miles off, in big cities like New York, Calcutta, we have seen people are coming to attend their office from 100 miles off. I have seen also in aeroplane there are many people. I have seen in England many workers or gentlemen, they are coming from Glasgow to London for working by aeroplane. So we have created a civilization that we have created a facility for transport by motor car or by aeroplane, but side by side we have created another difficulty that a man has to go to his work 300 miles away, side by side. Formerly, a man used to work on his field a few steps from his house. Now we have created facility of transport, therefore you have to go to work 300 miles away from home. This is the position. But they have no brain. They are thinking, they are advancing. Advancing in this way that for my livelihood I have to go 300 miles 3 hours at least, not less than 3 hours, or 6 hours. I have to spoil. Then I can go to my office. Then I work there whole day and again come, again 6 hours. Then I come at night to sleep along with my family for 3 hours. Yes. This is our facility. Yes. There is a story, not story, it is a fact. One day, one grown-up child was asking his mother, who is this gentleman? The father was there. So, the mother said, he is your father, my dear child. So he did not see his father until he grew 3 years or 4 years old. Because when he was child, the father was rising early in the morning. At that time child was sleeping. And he was going to office. And when he comes back, the child was sleeping. So unless the child grew 4 years old, he could not see his father. Is it not the position of this? It is a story or an instruction. Because the man, the gentleman was going office early in the morning. There are still, they start at 6 o'clock from home to catch the first train. We have seen in Calcutta. First train, the 7 o'clock. And they come in Calcutta after 2 hours and 9 o'clock. Then attends office. And again he catches another train, 5 o'clock, he goes late at night. And Bombay has big, big cities. This is the position. So we are advancing in science, but at the same time, the so-called science, at the same time we are creating many disadvantages. Many disadvantages. From practical experience, I say that when I came to your country, in India, it is very difficult to get a telephone. You have to wait in the waiting list at least for 2 years, or you have to bribe the authorities, say 5,000, 2,000, like that. When I got this facility of telephone, because as soon as I deposited $40, the next day the telephone was in my room. So I was very glad. But after getting my telephone, I was disturbed always. Some of my students asking, phoning me, kring, and, Swamiji, how are you feeling? At 12 o'clock at night. So I asked him, it is the time to inquire. I am very sorry. Not only one, I became so much disturbed. Then I asked them, get out this telephone. Yes. So try to understand the so-called facility of the modern science means creating so many difficulties also. That is the position. Just like formerly a preacher could not come to your country, say 50 years or 100 years ago. So he was preaching within his limit. But we have got not facilities, so we are preaching everywhere. So from Krishna consciousness, we can utilize all facilities in the proper channel, but not materially. Now, we are utilizing this facility of aeroplane. That means we are getting good chance for serving Krishna. But others, materialists, they are getting this facility so that his child cannot recognize him. So we can take all facilities. So therefore, we are actually utilizing the scientific improvement for the benefit of the people. The Kurmis, they cannot. They are in difficulties. So the Sankhya philosophy is analytical study of the elements of creation. Sammak khayate. Sammak means completely khayate. So how, first of all, there was vibration, then from vibration there was sky, creation, beginning of creation, and then from sky there was sound, then from sound there was air, then from air there was electricity or fire, then from electricity there was water, and from water there is land. This is shortly described. Then how this mind is created, intelligence is created, how the controller created, these are described in the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam also, in many places. So it is not that we are simply chanting and dancing, that is the ultimate goal of life. But we know how this creation has taken place, how it is being maintained, how it will be annihilated, what will happen after annihilation. Everything we know by the Sankhya philosophy. But they do not know. The so-called scientists, they are troubled what will happen next. So Kapila Muni is incarnation of God. He describes the Sankhya philosophy and Bhakti Yoga in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. His instructions are there. He was giving instruction to his mother, Devahuti. His father left him under the care of the mother. He went to forest for liberation. So when he grew up, he instructed his mother. Kapila Deva is known as Devahiti Putra, the son of Devahuti. All incarnation of God is famous especially by mother's name. Just like Krishna is famous by Jasodhananda, Devakinanda. He is very much pleased when his name is made in connection with his mother and father. Nandanandan, Vasudevanandan. Similarly, here also Devahuti Nandan. Devahuti Putra Kapila. So this Kapila Deva, Sankhya philosophy, has described how the elements came in, how the subtle elements, mind, intelligence, developed, how these gross elements, earth, water, fire, all these gross elements developed. So there are eight elements. They are described in Bhagavad Gita also. Five gross elements, earth, water, fire, air, ether, these are gross elements. And the subtle or finer elements are the mind, intelligence, ego. These are eight elements. And the subjects of sense perception and 10 sense organs. 10 sense organs, 5 subject matter of sense perception, 15, and these 8 elements, material elements, 15 and 8, 23, and Abhok are the living entity, and then God. In this way, the whole philosophy is described, that is called Sankhya philosophy. The Sankhya philosophy is always there, kala-viplutam. In due course of time, everything becomes invisible and unknown, just like Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita was spoken long, long ago, before speaking to Arjuna. Imam vivasati yogam praktabhanahamam. Therefore, all Vedic knowledge, they are not research knowledge. They are existing always since the time of creation. These so-called scientists, they are simply wasting their time by so-called research work. There is nothing to be researched. Everything is there. Every knowledge is there. How to make your life perfect, that is also there. But they would not consult this knowledge. They will try to make research and waste time and waste money, public money, and pass on as great scientists, philosophers, leaders, politicians, and mislead people without any factual knowledge. Now they are thinking at the present moment, the scientists, the things are diminishing. Actually, they will diminish. It is already stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. It will so diminish that there will be no more wheat, no more rice, no more food grains, no more fruits, and no more milk, no more sugar. It will finish. Simply, you have to eat stones and seeds and flesh. You will have. And the politician will go on exploiting it. Everything is written there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. You consult 12th canto, beginning from 2nd chapter, you will see all these things are mentioned. People will decrease their span of life, their intelligence, memory, their propensity for mercifulness and duration of life. So many things that will be reduced. You are seeing them being reduced. And people are becoming vagabonds. That is also stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, that when I first read in India this statement, Lavanyam Kesadharanam, that in this age, dwindling age, people will think of himself. One will think he has become very beautiful by keeping long hair. That is also mentioned. So when I came to your country, I saw these young people are keeping long hairs. So immediately it was corroborated. Similarly, everything is described there. The dampatye ratimeva hi. Husband and wife, relationship means sex. This is the age. As soon as the husband will be unable to satisfy his wife by sex, the wife find out another husband and file divorce. These are stated already in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and these are happening. And a man, when he lived for 20 to 30 years, he will be considered a grand old man. These are all stated. So why research? You consult Vedic literature, you have got all information, everything. How the world is created, how it will be annihilated, how it is being maintained, who is the supreme in this management, everything is there. That is called Sankhya philosophy. Everything is there. So Kapiladeva, he gave us this Sankhya philosophy. Later on, there was another, he imitated, he also named himself a Kapila, and he gave the same philosophical process, Sankhya Kapila. There is Nirisha, he is godless. Because all the scientists, all the philosophers in this age, their only tendency is how to get out God, no more God. That is very primitive. To talk of God is a primitive idea. Now we are advanced in science, why we shall talk about God? This is the tendency. This is the tendency. But how you can solve all this question without accepting God? Without accepting a supreme source of everything, how you can solve? It is not possible. You are simply a product of this cosmic manifestation. Your brain, your teeny brain, is composed of some muscles and veins. That is product of this material world. You cannot even produce a brain. Just consider, can you produce a brain? You are eulogizing a great scientist like Professor Einstein. All right, why not Professor Einstein creating a brain like him? Why? What is the difficulty? He may create a brain like him and keep it in the glass case so that there will be no shortage of scientific men. But why he dies? Why he dies? Who is forcing him to death? Why he becomes diseased? Why he becomes old man? Who is controlling? So, to accept the supreme controller is a must question. You must. Without it, you cannot go forward. You must have to accept. We can appreciate the brain of a scientist, but who has created that brain? We are seeing to that person who has created, not to the brain. Just like a child appreciates a motor car, how it is running, but his father appreciates the driver, how the driver is running nicely. So therefore, we should not be surprised by the creation or the working of material nature. We should appreciate who is conducting, who is the background of this material nature. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhakshina prakriti syati sacharacharam hitunani na kontiya jagad bi parivartate. He says, maya dhakshina, under my direction, Krishna says, prakriti, this material nature, is working. Maya dhakshina. Let's see how it is working. How prakriti is working. Just like in this month in your country, it is called fall, September. After a few days, all the leaves will fall down. Again in April, immediately millions of leaves will grow, immediately. If you have to manufacture this leaf one after another and set up in the tree, just see how much difficult it will be. But by the laws of nature, by God's energy, immediately, within a few days, millions of trees are getting their leaves again, and millions of trees they are falling. Millions of fruits are coming out. Similarly, all this cosmic manifestation came into existence simply by the will of God. Just like in season, there are hundreds and thousands and millions of fruits. You haven't got to create each fruit. When the season is there, the fruits are already, immediate. Similarly, when God says, let there be creation, millions of planets immediately create. That is God. Not that cheap God. I am God. In your country, they come and you become cheated. We don't accept such cheap God. We want this God. Simply by His will, millions of universes are created. Jasyaika nishyasita kala mathavalamma jivanti lomo vilaja jagadanna natha Vishnu mahanasa yajasya kalavisesho govinna madhipurisam. Come on. We are not seeking after a cheap God, a real God. That is Krishna. That is Krishna. Govinna madhipurisam tamang bhajami. So we are not so fooled that why? We shall make research. Everything is there. So you are confident, we know what is going to happen next. It is not astrology. Everything is there in the Vedic knowledge. Veda means knowledge, full knowledge. You take advantage of it and become learned. Thank you.
Yeah.